velike čast da vam se pozdravim i želim vam dobrodošli u klinici u mentalnom zdravlju. Naša ustanova od samog svog nastanka, evo gotovo punih 5 decenija, nego je se uvijek stigno da radijski rad sa pacijentima i koliko to naš tretman dozvoljava, nego i psihoanalitički. Današnje gosta će mi najaviti psihoanalitički društva Jasmina Sujević, a ja ću također da vas pozdravim u ime akademika Dušica Lečić-Tošetski, direktora naše ustanove koja je izražava žaljenje jer je po bolesti danas bila sreća nego doći.
Ljubno svime, ja samo da vas u ime psihoanalitičkog društva Srbije sve pozdravim. Drago mi je da smo se okupili, nadam se da ćemo uživati svi zajedno. Hvala Institutu za mentalno zdravlje za ovo gostoprimstvo i hvala našem gostu što će nam izlagati ovo predavanje. Toliko, Marija će sada da predstavi naše goste.
Vrlo kratko, da mu uzimamo puno vremena od samog predavanja. Naša opasnost je Zemljena Lista Biznice psihoanalitičke društva i član Francuske psihoanalitičke asocijacije. Završio je prvi stepen na Oxfordu u klasičnoj literaturi filozofije, posle toga isto medicine, specijalizira psihijatriju. I autor je nekoliko knjiga, puno radova i psihoanalitičke literaturi, to se kaže na našem poslu, da se interesuje za teoriju i psihoanalizu i oblasti ljudskog znanja. U tom smislu je i ovo predavanje o odnosu psihoanalize i umetnosti. Zahvaljujem se i ja i Institutu, zahvaljujem se svima vama i zamolila bih za naša partnerka, naša gosta, da znači svoje izlaganje. Sve naša gosta.
Thank you.
Very much, Maria. Is this going to work? Can you hear me? Or the microphone is on. So good. So, well, thank you very much, Maria, for introducing me and inviting me here. I'm very, very pleased to be here. My only regret is that I can't speak in Serbian. You have to listen to me speaking in English. But Maria has done a wonderful job of translating the paper and be able to read it up there.
Znači, pozdravljam sve, zahvaljujem se i veoma mi žao zbog toga što ne umem da govorim.
So, psychoanalysts listen both externally to their patients and internally to whatever thoughts and feelings they find that this stirs up in themselves. They try to be inwardly sensitive to the relationships they get drawn into in this way. In analytic language, the transference and counter-transference, reflecting this understanding back outwards again, they work with their patients as creatively as they can. Artists look intently at the world around them and are sensitive at the same time to the internal resonances it arouses in them. Like animals, they are imaginatively open to the relationship they find themselves drawn into with the world and seek to reflect in their work as creative as possible and understanding of it. Both the analysts listening and the artists looking are double processes. They are directed outwards and inwards at the same time, with each aspect essential, continuously active, and interdependent. An artist came to me for analysis because his creativity was blocked. He felt felt she had lost this emotional responsivity and was not generating any new artistic ideas. He said, as I recollected it later, that he had become a maker of things rather than an investigator of states of mind. I remembered the impression his voice made on me. They seemed an interesting description of what being an artist means to me, and there were echoes in them of what I think it means to be a psychoanalyst. But when I looked back at my notes, I found my memory was mistaken. He had not said states of mind. He said he had become a maker of things rather than an investigator of states of being. His words must originally have evoked in me the thought that an analyst too could be an investigator of states of being. But it seems that I needed to repress and assimilate it to an apparently more manageable idea of an analyst as one who deals with states of mind. What happened to my first response? What this man actually said gave me a momentary sense, not just of understanding, but of recognition. Then I let go of it, opting instead to investigate states of mind. For an analyst to retreat like this from the challenge of an artist's actual communication back into what he knows already is a familiar scenario. Confronted in Rome by the Moses of Michelangelo, Freud asked, somewhat plaintively, why should the artist's intention not be capable of being communicated and comprehended in words, like any other fact of mental life? To discover the artist's intention, he said, quote, I must first find out the meaning and content of what is represented in the work. I must, in other words, be able to interpret it. In his paper, The Unconscious, written soon after this, Freud discussed what he called thing presentations and word presentations. Thing presentations consist simply of remote, unconscious memory traces. Word presentations consist of thing presentations with the addition of words to refer to. Only if something is available as a word presentation, says Freud, can it become conscious and be thought about. The works of art are things, not words. Even when made out of words, they are still things. This was vividly brought home to me when I met the author of a remarkable novel. Having been intensely moved by the book, I was interested to ask the author about the experience of writing it. I asked the author about the experience of writing this book. He was happy to talk, but what he had to say seems to me banal compared to the power of the novel itself.
Samo zlomirajte.
Hvala.